Hi everyone, welcome back to another Placeit tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create designs for merch on Twitch. These are some examples of the designs you can create. As you can see, there's over 300 different pages to choose from. Then I'm going to show you how to put these onto mockups so you can show people what these designs actually look like. And then lastly, in this video, I'm going to show you how to create your own storefront with these items using print on demand so you don't have to actually print these products. Whenever a viewer places an order, it'll automatically be printed and sent to them. What's cool about doing it the way that I'll show you in this video is it integrates directly with Twitch. All right, without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. All right, so in today's video, we're going to be using Placeit.net to create these designs and the mockup images. If you are new to Placeit.net, it's one of the biggest graphic design tools out there. It's the fastest growing, and when you compare it to the other graphic design tools, they have the most features. They have mockups, they have designs, logos, videos, and over 70,000 different templates to choose from. Now, Placeit is a paid tool to use. It's about $15 per month. That gives you unlimited downloads. However, down in the description is my referral link over to Placeit, and with that comes 15% off. So it brings the monthly price down to about $12.70. You only need this for a month if you're just going to create a bunch of designs. There are no contracts, so you don't have to keep it forever. All right, with all of that out of the way, let's go ahead and get started with this tutorial. So that link in the description will bring you right to where I am. This is the homepage of Placeit. What we're going to do is hover over designs and go to t-shirt designs. Now this tutorial is going to show you how to create designs that you can put on any merch on Twitch. This can be t-shirts, this can be coffee mugs, this can be hoodies or sweatshirts, even wall tapestries or wall art. So with that being said, the t-shirt design section is going to give you the most templates to choose from. And these designs can be put on any of those different items we just talked about. So once you're here, you can either just scroll through these templates and look for something that's interesting or fits your Twitch channel, or you can come to the left side and you can sort these by different categories. Now once you find one that you like, I'm going to use this one for example, all you have to do is click on it. This will bring you right into the design editor here on Placeit. Now there's some really cool features over on this right side that I can't wait to get into, but first we need to start with the basics. On the left side is your text. So each one of these boxes is going to correspond to something on this template. And this eye icon is going to say if that line of text is turned on or if it's turned off. So this one is turned off. So let's see what that one is if we do turn it back on. Okay, so this is actually not going to be usable for us. That's if you want to add some kind of shadow or different text behind your original text. I'm just going to turn that one back off. So this is going to be the text that we're working with on this design. So obviously just highlight this and you can change what the text says. If you come down here, you can move the text anywhere. You can change the size of this text. Everything will snap into place. And if you want to go back to the original layout, all you have to do is hit reset layout. Now beyond actually changing the text here, you can change your font. You'll have a ton of different options here. If there's something specific you're looking for, just hit more fonts and you can scroll through even more fonts or you can search for one specifically. Next up on fonts is the colors. So you can hit the dropdown. Again, you can choose from the defaults or hit more, use the sliders or enter a specific color hex code. So that's it for fonts on the left side over here, pretty simple. Now coming over to the right side. So the most important thing when creating a design for merch is to make sure that the background is transparent. If we were to leave this background gray and we uploaded this design onto a t-shirt or a coffee mug, it would print this gray background. And if that's not the look that you're going for, then we need to do one step. That's hitting this drop down over here and switching it to the checkerboard. This is going to make that background completely transparent so we can put this on any color shirt or coffee mug or sweatshirt and it will only print the design and not any colored background. Next up, we get to change the color of this graphic here. So again, if you want to move the graphic around, change the size, you can do that. And you can change the colors and the accent colors of the design itself. Now this brings us to a good point. If you hit a color and you don't like it, you can either manually go back to the color you started with, or you can click off of here and hit the back button on your internet browser. Not many people know that on Placeit, you can use your browser's back button to undo a change. Since there is no back button in this editor, it's a good little trick to know. Now beyond the main color, you can go down to your accent color, and again, you can do the same thing. You can change any colors you want here. And then this is the part that I like best about Placeit. So Placeit has a massive library of commercially usable graphics. That means you can use any of these graphics and you don't have to buy the rights to use them. So depending on which template you chose, it's going to sort you into a specific category. If you see something you like, all you have to do is click it and it'll work it right into your design. And if there's something specific you're looking for, you can type in a different category and it will give you a ton of other graphics to choose from. Now again, to undo any of this, all we do is hit the undo button. It'll bring us right back to where we were. So that is the bulk of how to create your design here. Now let's move on to the next section of how to create your mockups to show off what your merch looks like. So once this design is ready to go, all we hit is download. And you'll see this across the board whenever you're creating something on Placeit. When you hit download, it'll have this processing your design pop up. A couple seconds later, it'll say click to download. And just like that, we can click, it'll download right to our computer. Now just to see what this looks like, we can click and open this up. And we've got this awesome design for merch. As you see, when you zoom in, the quality on these are awesome and it has a transparent background. We can put that on any product color. So this is now saved to our computer. So I'm just going to leave that there, come back to Placeit. Now let's go over to the mockups and I'll show you how to create mockups to show off your merch. So from this page, we're just going to hover over mockups and go to mockup generator. And it really is going to be as easy as dragging and dropping, and it puts it onto the different mockups you choose. So as you scroll through here, you can see different mockups to choose from. And if there's a specific product that you're looking for, you can find it on the left side over here, or you can type it in up top, make sure you're in the mockups category, and you can find all of the different mockups they have for that product. So for this example, I'm just going to create a simple t-shirt mockup to show you how this works. Now, generally on these mockups, you don't need to add any text. You really just want the image. So we're going to go to insert image, and then this will give you two options: upload from your device, which means upload from your computer, or import from downloads, which is going to pull from your previous Placeit downloads. So if you want to use a design that you created a long time ago and you don't exactly know where that is on your computer, just hit import from downloads and then you'll be able to pull it from your previous download history on your Placeit account. Now, since I just downloaded this design to my computer, I'm just going to hit upload from your device. Now, once you select your design, it's going to bring it right into this crop area. We just want to move it up into about the center of the t-shirt. Since this is a t-shirt design, not a mug design, we want this in the upper half of the shirt. Then we can just hit crop and it'll show you what it looks like on this shirt. Now, if you think that that's a little bit too low, you want to move it up a little higher, just hit resize again and you can move it up higher on the shirt. Now, something good to know is we have white text on a white shirt. So how do we fix that? Well, all we have to do is come over to shirt color, switch this to any color that is not white, and our white text will show up. Then the last thing with these mockups is you hit your background color and you can change it to any color that you want. So that should take care of all of your colors and basically the bulk of creating a mockup. If you do hit add a graphic, you can add in your own logo or choose from their library again if you do want to add something or some kind of information to this mockup. The majority of the time, this is going to be your completed mockup. No text, no graphics, and then we just hit download just like before. We'll just give this a couple seconds to load, and then we can click and download it right to our computer again. Okay, so just like that, we created a merch design. We put it on a mockup to show people what it looks like. Now the last part of this process is how do we actually sell these products? Well, if you're anything like me, you're not a t-shirt printer. You don't have a t-shirt printing facility ready to go. So the best way to do this is to use the print on demand business model. Now the best website for this, in my opinion, is teespring.com. All we have to do is create virtual listings of what these products would look like and upload our design. And then we can create a storefront, integrate it directly with Twitch. And when anyone purchases any of the products that we created, Teespring does all the printing in their factory. They ship it out to the customer. And then if there's any need for returns or customer service, Teespring does all of that as well. Essentially, once you upload your designs and create these virtual listings, you don't have to lift another finger. You basically just see the profit from all of the sales add up in your account as people are ordering these products. So once you come over to Teespring, just create an account and hit start designing up top. And then you can upload your designs, you can choose which products they're listed on and how much you want to sell them for, how big of a profit margin you want to have. And then once you have your listings made, scroll all the way down to the bottom, go to Twitch integrations, and you can activate your merch store over on Twitch. Then when people are watching your stream, right below it, all of your different products will be available for purchase. Now in this tutorial, I'm not going to go into how to create the listings and do all of the logistics that go along with Teespring. However, I will link up a full tutorial that goes step by step through this whole process. Now the tutorial that I'm going to link up for you guys down in the description is going to go over really how to start a full-on t-shirt business. Now I understand for most of you guys, you're just trying to create merch for Twitch and not a full-on t-shirt business. However, it will have all of the information on how to create your storefront and your listings and best practices in there. Now, something pretty cool that I wanted to show you is that this is the account that I use just for creating tutorials on Teespring. And as you can see, just from uploading a few designs while making tutorials and showing you guys how to create these listings, I've actually made sales and made $9 profit from these shirts selling themselves. So if you're interested in how this full-on t-shirt business works beyond just creating the merch for Twitch, then I think you may be interested in that tutorial linked below. So all in all, hopefully this tutorial has been helpful for you to get you the bulk of the way to creating your own merch for Twitch and being able to sell it on your streams. Remember, the link down in the description for Placeit gives you 15% off, so hopefully that helps you to get started by lowering the price. Again, if you have any questions about anything here on Placeit or on Teespring, just let me know down in the comments. I'd be happy to help you out. All right, guys, that's it for this one. I hope it has been helpful, and I will see you all in the next Placeit tutorial.